All right, if I could have your attention, if you could find your seat, we're going to go ahead and get started. Thank you for your patience as we waited for setup and family to enter. But we are going to go ahead and welcome the bridal party, and so go ahead. Before you're seated, I'd like to welcome you here today, family and friends and body of Christ gathered to celebrate today. You're here to celebrate this wonderful celebration of a life together in Christ. Each one of you is here to help add to the enjoyment of their day, and I want to thank you for staying and being a part of that. The commitment of Eric and Reb here today demonstrates to us the eternal love that they have for each other. And that eternal love is found in the Lord. And so let us bow in prayer as we thank him today for that eternal love. Heavenly Father, what a joy it is to know that the couple is grounded in you, that they want most of all this to be a reflection of who you are, God. And even down to the song that is traditional for a bride to enter to, that wasn't played because they wanted glory to be brought to you, that the Lord God Almighty reigns, and we can sing Alleluia. So I just thank you for this time that we get to continue in worship of who you are, Lord. We ask all of these things in your Son's name. Amen. You may be seated. One of the things that Eric and Reb wanted as a part of their ceremony and before they make their vows to each other, is they wanted to demonstrate the power of Jesus in their lives to the rest of you. And they wanted to start their ceremony with communion. The power of Jesus Christ is undeniable in their lives. And they both hold that as the highest priority in their relationship. The sacrifice of Jesus Christ giving his body and blood as the perfect sacrifice so that all that accept him as Savior receive forgiveness from their sins and eternal life with him. That's all symbolized by communion. Instead of doing the traditional unity candle, Eric and Reb have decided to demonstrate their unity in Christ first before they vow to each other. Eric and Reb, would you please approach the communion table? Luke 22, 19 through 20 says that he took the bread. Go ahead. And when he had given thanks, which we have done, he broke it and he gave it to them, saying, "This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Likewise, Jesus took the cup after they had eaten, and he said, "This is the cup which is poured out for you, and it's the new covenant in my blood. Do it in remembrance of him." Let me pray. Father, thank you for the heart of this couple, which is just shining through, and how that heart is united as one already through Christ. And I just pray now, as we move into the vows that they have for each other, I just pray that this relationship individually between Eric and you, God, and between Reb and you, God, would be as strong as ever and continually growing stronger through their marriage. Thank you for their heart, like I said, that's shining through in this ceremony. We continue to dedicate it to you in your son's name. Amen. You may approach back. I don't know if you remember a few weeks ago when they were baptized, and there's quite a difference between one of them had plenty to say and the other one is someone of very few words. So they will not be reading their vows to each other. They are just going to listen to me read them, but they want these to be very meaningful and filled with Scripture and who God is. So their vows are based on, again, their heart for the Lord. So, Eric, as you stand before both God and man, do you take Reb to be your wife, making this commitment before God who brought you together to love and cherish her as Christ loved the church and he gave himself for it, to lead her as you submit to God's authority, and to share all of life's experiences with her by following God through them, that through his grace, you and Reb might grow together into the likeness of Jesus Christ, your Savior and Lord. If you agree, please respond by saying, "I do." Reb, as you stand before both God and man, do you take Eric to be your husband, making this commitment before God who brought you together to love and cherish him, to submit to his leadership, as he submits to God's authority, and to follow him through all of life's experiences as he follows God, that through God's grace, you and Eric might grow together into the likeness of Jesus Christ, your Savior and Lord. If you agree, please respond by saying, "I do." As a symbol of the eternal love of God, these two have chosen to exchange rings today. These rings show the world of commitment that you two have for each other. And as I read, would you please place them on each other's fingers? A ring is endless, and it has no beginning and no end. Let this shape remind not only you, but all of you here, of their vow to God, and let your commitment and love be the same, eternal, consistent, strong, never-ending. Though one or two people can defend themselves but eventually be overpowered, a cord of three strands is not easily broken, and your union today between the two of you and God is that cord of three strands. Not only did Eric and Reb want to vow to each other and exchange rings, but they wanted your participation as well. So all of you who are gathered, we have seen the commitment and love that this couple has for each other and for Christ. However, they have asked for your support. Do you, members of the body of Christ, promise to support this couple as they seek Christ in their marriage and lives? Do you promise to hold them up in prayer and give them guidance based on the wisdom that you have been given from God? If you agree in this way, please respond by saying, "We do." Praise the Lord. Based on your guys' commitment today to make Christ the center of your marriage and the source of your love for each other, I can officially pronounce you husband and wife. As Scripture states in Matthew 19:6, "So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no one separate." Praise the Lord. Eric, it's your privilege to kiss your bride. Friends and family, it's my pleasure to introduce to you guys for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Eric Freeburg.
When you pull over and I jump in, into your little red Mercedes Benz, well, I know there's no turning back. I don't even care where we are. I just wanna be inside your car. You can drive me wild, baby. You can drive me crazy. You just drive me, I don't care with you. I'll go anywhere, clean out of sight. Once around the moon, anyway we go, I'll be fine, just as long as I'm with you. Well, it don't matter when we get back, this ain't the time to talk about that. You can drive me wild, baby. You can drive me crazy. You just drive me, I don't care.
All right. Thank you guys so much for celebrating with this couple today. Please go ahead and stay after for the great meal. If you need to leave, that's fine, but we'd love to have you stay for the fellowship and the food and the wedding cake. So you are dismissed. Thank you.